Now, just deploy. Okay, everything is done now. And we should be in like around 20 minutes, 15 minutes, we should be up and running with the Hadoop pseudonode cluster where HDFS service is up and running.
In the higher version of HDB, HDB 2.6 or 2.7.3, is there any option to directly install the name node and the standby name node? The name node HA options directly in the higher version of HDB.
No.
Do we need to always enable that name node HA and install first that second name node?
So what you are trying to ask is basically directly we can make HA or not, right? Or we will first even in that case also we need to first install the HDFS and then through Ambari only we can make HA.
Okay.
And HA is a very good terminology, basically high availability, right? High availability, you should always keep your mind open that what all the things you can make highly available to your customers or to your cluster access, whoever you accessing your cluster. There are multiple components which we can make high HA, like name node HA, resource manager HA, Edgebase HA, UZI server HA, high meta store HA, high server 2 HA, then you need to HA the MySQL database, then you need to make HA of UZI server, we already decided, so UZI server HA, how do you need to make, so then you need to make HA of either Cloudera manager and Cloudera Ambari server, we need to think on how to make it HA, I mean basically there should be two instances of Ambari server that can run, okay. And if one goes down, the other can be accessed. But then again, it is not meant for developers, so and it is not that much critical. So we can keep running only one instance of Ambari server. But then again, you need to think on the HA of Hue server, HUE, through which all these components are accessed as a web UI. Okay, so I will let you know on that and how to make it. Then you need to make it, you need to make anything that just provide a very critical service, you need to think on that how to make its HA, high availability, okay, and how to do the load balancing so that let's say if you are having 200 or 100 of users who are actually accessing your cluster, okay, so how to ensure that each user should be routed properly because if you are there are multiple instances of same service are running. Not only one instance should get all the users get interacted with and the remaining instances may be free. So you should not do that. Let's suppose if you are running three instances of let's say one service, all the three instances should get a proper load of the users to connect to it. Okay. It should not happen that first 100 user first connect to this instance number one and then the two instances are still free. Okay. So that kind of load balancing also in place. So all that is under, it's very, interesting and that kind of activity, how to this load balancing and HA, you will keep listening it multiple times. Okay, so there are multiple load balancer, I'm not sure like how. So in Linux world basically there is HA proxy, there is Nginx server, there are so many small utilities out, that we need to just learn ad hoc. Okay, that is not the core part of Hadoop, but still around Hadoop there are a lot of things that you need to learn. You need to know that how to set it up, how to make it interaction, how to make that interaction happen with Hadoop. Okay, so Hadoop in itself is nothing. I mean what we are doing is just kind of, this is Hadoop is finished. Okay, we are good and now you are allow the users to access this Hadoop and then that's it. But still we need to provide security, we need to secure our cluster in such a way that no normal user can come and do anything whatever he wants, right? So even the HDFS, it is Hadoop distributed file system, it is accessible to the developer, but still you need to figure it out, or depending on the business rules and whatever the, you know, developers managers say, that he should not have access to this directory, he should not have access to this file, he should not have access to any table or a columns of table. There are multiple things that you may need to restrict. Okay, so by default you should restrict everything and open only when the manager asks, okay, so this access should be given. By default, everything should be restricted. That is the best policy. Okay, you cannot make everything by default to be open to all, otherwise they will just come and, you know, play with the things. So the best policy, restrict everything to everybody, and then slowly open the things by referring to any incident, by referring to any request. Okay, just like, so that it will be properly documented everywhere, that why we have given that particular request or particular authority to that that particular developer, right? Everything should be documented so that nobody will blame you that why you have given that permission without any permission. Okay, success. Next. Complete. And now you will see some Ambari. So this is how it looks like. Okay, this is HDFS. Currently we have not installed Ambari Matrix. Otherwise you could have seen all these graphs and charts, beautiful charts that will tell you about what is happening with your single machine. Currently we do have only two services active, it is HDFS and Zookeeper. If you want to add service, you can come to action and say add service and then select whatever services you want. Currently those are not checked, are not installed. Those are checked or installed, right? So here we see that Zookeeper and HDFS, they are already checked, it means they are already available. So you may not to select them again. But rest, either Uzi, Scoop, you can just select and you can do the installation of it. Okay. Then you will see this is secondary name node. I mean, you can go to dashboard. So dashboard will just show you some quick things about, sorry, like what is the space usage of HDFS, what is, how many data nodes are live currently, how many of them are dead or decommissioned. Then we do have some links of name node, secondary name node, data nodes. This is these are furthermore. Then you can go to services. In services tabs, you will get all the services and where they are actually installed. Go to hosts. It will tell that only one host is there. If you open it, it will tell you that within this host, how many services are installed. Okay. And how many of them are started and running. So basically they are all started. Green means they are all running. Then you have some alerts. These are all alerts that are already set up. They are all enabled. You may need to set up your own alert, but basically there are, like, you know, actions. You can manage alert groups, manage notification. These are all Ambari 41, HDFS default 35. And these are HDFS 35 alerts already there. Okay, so you can just modify them. I have never seen any admin to install or to create a new alert, though there is a way to create or add a new alert in Ambari. Okay, but most of the general alerts already been set up and you can just use them out of box. And these are some admin console, and you will see, you can go to admin and you can sign it out. You can go to settings, manage Ambari. So you can come here now. If you go to users, basically you will see that only one user is currently there in user section. You can add multiple users over here. Okay, so you can bring those users from either Active Directory or whatever. So you can say create local user, so it will create a local user. Then groups also similar way. So you should have only one group available called admin, I think, if it is there. No, it's not there. You can create roles. roles in terms of, well, this is cluster administrator, cluster operators, these are all available, you know, roles. So when you say cluster administrator, if you add any user over here, okay, from your local Linux, so basically that user will get all the administrator privileges. If you say cluster user, so this is the most restrictive one. So whenever any developer will come, add them here. Okay, so it is just cluster user. He does not see any options of managing the cluster from the Ambari. So they will have the access to Ambari, but then they can't do further. It's like kind of read only for them. Then you can, you know, these are some roles, and you can assign the users and group to these roles so that they will have that kind of authority on the cluster. Views, basically these are all views. You can have capacity scheduler, view, file, you know, pig, slider, age, stage, zeppelin. So you can then create multiple instances of views, and then those views are actually available here. So go to Ambari. And come here and okay, so once you assign the views to the user, it will come over here. And file views, currently this is the only view available. Okay, service checks completed. These are the HDFS view basically. It tells you that there are only two directories in HDFS. Okay, so on the backend, if you want to access your Hadoop distributed file system, just do Hadoop fs minus ls. So this is what you just need to add before every Linux command, and it will become a Hadoop command. Hadoop fs hyphen, just put everything in front of the Linux directory commands, and you are actually doing the Hadoop commands. So currently these are the directories from the Hadoop file system, not your local file system, because your local file system, it does have these many directories. So ls means it is actually accessing a local file system, and when you put Hadoop fs hyphen in front of ls, it is accessing your Hadoop distributed file system. Okay, so this is a very, you know, initial overview of that, how we can access it.
Mehman, one thing. From my knowledge, I think on the Ambari access only three.
Your voice is breaking. No, you're not at all audible. Anybody is hearing Prashant? Prashant, you're not audible. If you're hearing me, you can write down your question in chat. Maybe his net has gone. Maybe he's still speaking. Yeah, now it has come. It is coming.
Basically, I got a phone in between, so. Okay. So only three level of accesses are possible. Admin access, then operational access, and then read-only access, right? So admin access, like you will have access to all the services, like to start, restart,
yes.
Manage Ambari.
Yes.
On the operational level access, operations team will have access to restart all the services, but they don't be having access to manage Ambari, and the read only access is just to like read only.
So this is more you can say this is more open cluster administrator, and this is the least open, and everything in between you will have kind of some things are some cluster operation he can perform, but not a full administrator privileges will be given to him, service administrator and service operator. Okay, so these roles are already set. I'm not sure how to make some changes in that. Go to dashboard version, remote cluster, block, list. Okay, so currently, we just need to assign the user to this role. So admin is a cluster administrator. So this is a prime role. Now he can give the roles to other administrators or other cluster users. But these are the hierarchy, or you can say these are like the sub categories. So these are the categories of privileges basically that you can get on Ambari. I mean, was it your question or what? I did not understand. Was it?
No, just
okay. Okay. Okay.
I think I was just sharing
my. Okay. 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 Good. So yes, and then we do have remote cluster. Basically, remote cluster, you can add register remote cluster. Basically, if you are having multiple clusters, there is only not one cluster that you are going to manage. There may be tens or twenties of clusters, basically depending on. So one cluster may have 100 nodes. So you are actually, you know, managing independent clusters of Hadoop. Okay, cluster to cluster data copy, backup recovery, that all things can be the activities day to day on basis you will do. So if you want to manage the register remote cluster through the same Ambari console, basically you can do that. Okay, and you can switch on, switch between multiple clusters in order to manage them directly through one console. Okay, so let's say thousands of machines, you are just sitting on one kind of a pilot, GUI based web interface and managing everything. So I think that's enough, and we have got the working model of our pseudonode cluster. So this is just for your overview. I mean, this is how actually the Hadoop looks like. Okay, there are multiple further components we can add and then make it more and more involved, more users and all. Currently it is just serving you the data storage of Hadoop distributed file system that you can access, you can put the file, you can create the directory and do all the Linux directory level activities on it. So that's it for now. Next weekend we do not have class. Next weekend I will let you know which day we will have. Only one day or 2 days. 2 days may be possible, but maybe only one day I can take, and then from that point onwards we will have no break and we will finish it up. Okay, and we will try to cover both. So currently we started with HDP, since I do have the things ready with me. We need to do the same thing for Clouder also, and we'll use a Google Cloud for it. Currently, why I used only single node, because that much how I can provide from this machine. Okay, so currently if you see the settings, I have given almost 5 GB of RAM. I cannot create 3 or 4 node cluster on my machine, it would be very slower. Okay, so we will go to Google Cloud and create everything over there now. Okay, there we will refer to the public repository, because the Google Cloud internet is very fast. It downloads the things in Mbps, 40 Mbps per second kind of thing, 40 MB per second. So even though your Hortonworks public repository is slow, or no, and since we will require it for only learning purpose, so we are not going to upload this 5 GB of our local repository, make our own HTTP server. So we will have HTTP server, but then we will refer to all the public repositories of Hortonworks and Cloudera in order to install the things over there. Okay, so that's it from my side for today. No question. If you do not have any question, we are good. If you have any question, ask. No questions?
Mimant, I'll call you for 5 minutes after this class.
Okay. After creating cluster, basically this is just like the overview of how to create a cluster. Basically we need to add now more services, and now we need to start using this cluster to provide the data ingestion, data handling and data analytics on